Hello guys, welcome to Amit Thinks. In this video, we will learn how to install the current MySQL version on Windows 10. For that, let us go to the web browser. I am using Chrome, you can use any web browser. On Google, type MySQL and press enter. The official website is now visible, mysql.com, click on it. mysql.com started, click downloads. After clicking downloads, go below. Go to MySQL community downloads. Click on it. On clicking, the community download section is visible. Herein, click on MySQL installer for Windows. Now the current version 8.0.35 is visible. And for Windows, it got selected on its own. 32-bit is visible, but this works for 64-bit as well. And herein I'll go for the second one, that is 288 MB. Click download. Now click on no thanks, just start my download, you don't need to log in. The download started. Here it is, let's wait. The download completed, right click on the MSI file. Click open to begin the installation. Minimize. The setup started. Select the setup type here. I'll go for the custom so that you can understand what we are actually installing. Click next. Now the select products section is visible. Here and go for MySQL servers, click on it, click the drop down again and here again and select MySQL server 8.0.35. x64 means for 64-bit, click here to drag it, it will drag here. Fine, go to applications, go to MySQL shell 8.0, click on shell 8.0.35 and drag it here. That's it. This is what we wanted, click next. Now check requirements, you need to install Microsoft Visual C++ also. When you'll click here, it will give you all the information for both. So no problem, this failed requirement will vanish after you'll click on execute, because clicking execute will install this software from the official website of Microsoft. Click execute. Now you can see it is installing. Now click I agree and click install to install the software Visual C++. The setup is successful, click close. Now you can see the installation is done for the Visual C++, click next. Installation, now the products will install, both server and shell, click execute. Installation started. The installation completed for both server and shell. Click next. Product configuration, click next. Type and networking, it will take 3306 as port, keep it as it is and click next. Authentication method, it is recommended that go for a strong password encryption, that is a strong password, which is fine, keep the default and click next. Now set up your password. So this is your own password, root password. That is, you are the admin of the server. You need to add your own password because people get confused a lot of times. So I'll enter a password. You can use my password. This will be useful while logging your MySQL server. I'll show you. Click next. Windows service, click next. Server file permissions, your database will get saved in the following location. Keep it as default, yes. Keep it as default, yes, grant full access, click next. Apply configuration, click on execute. And one by one, it will install each and every step here. Click execute, and here it is. It is installing one by one. Configuration successful, click finish. Now click next. Installation complete, click finish, and it will also open the MySQL shell, click finish. Now minimize. Now the last step is the following. Go to your location, C drive, wherein you installed MySQL program files, MySQL, MySQL server, go to bin. Here it is, copy this path, right click and copy, minimize, go to start, type environment variables, click on edit the system environment variables here, click here, open, open. Now under advanced, click environment variables, go to system variables, here in the path is visible, double click, click new, right click and paste the same path, the bin path remember. Click OK, OK, and the last OK, that's it. Now, we are done with the installation, go to start, type cmd, click on open to open the command prompt. Now here in type MySQL space hyphen hyphen version and press enter. This shows that we successfully installed MySQL 8.0.35. Now let us log in to a server, MySQL hyphen u. Root space hyphen p. So what is this? Hyphen u is for user, that is our user is root. If you remember, the user was root, you are the admin of your MySQL server. Hyphen p means your password. Press enter. Enter the password, the same password you remember you said before. Press enter again. Now you will enter your MySQL. Here it is, you have entered it. Here it is, you have entered it. Now type show databases and semicolon, press enter. This will show the default databases. Now let us quickly create a database using the create database and the database name, that is my database name is now AmitDB, semicolon, press enter. Query OK means you successfully created a new database AmitDB. Type the same command, show databases, semicolon and press enter. Now your database would be visible AmitDB. Now it is 5, it was 4 before. Now if you want to learn how to create a table and work on other MySQL operations, refer the link in the description of this video to get a free MySQL course on YouTube. Thank you for watching the video.